Welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Steve Jackson's Sorcery. Now beginning episode 2, Khare, Cityport of Traps. I'm the RPG Chick, and this is a Let's Play which you can vote for what I do at the end and of each episode. So it's an interactive Let's Play of a sorts, and you know, some people seem to be enjoying it. So anyway, the Crown of Kings has been stolen by the Archmage and taken across the backlands to Mampang. It's been sent to get it back. Should you fail, the whole of Kakabad will surely fall. A journey began. From the outpost settlement in Analand, you crossed the Shamutanti Hills. Along the way, you explored an abandoned city of giants, traveled with a mini-mite who almost cost you your life, and fought and killed the dreaded manticore. You face starvation and disease. A test of character. I really like this music, by the way. To survive, you used your blade rarely, and your intelligence frequently, but always acted cautiously, with honor and compassion. Your spirit guide changed as you changed, becoming the gorilla. But now all of that seems a distant memory, for you are approaching Khare, the Cityport of Traps. Founded on a fort of the Jabaji River, Khare was once a camp for the pirates who ambushed merchants sailing from Lake Lumley to the sea. But the camp grew. It became a village, the village became a town, and now Khare is a magnet for ne'er-do-wells and thieves, ruled over by a council of villains. It cannot be avoided. You would go around it if you could, but on the far side is the North Gate, the only entrance to the backlands and the next stage of your journey. For the good of the kingdom, you must enter the Cityport of Traps and make it out alive. Inkle presents Steve Jackson's Sorcery. Part 2, Khare, Cityport of Traps. Dun-dun-dun-dun. So, look at all these, though. I thought all these posts were places that we had already been. We can't travel to them. That's very odd. So, how do I do this exactly? Because... oh, okay. I was like, I'm trying to move him somewhere, and there's nowhere to go. Twilight already. The great city of Khare has loomed large on the horizon all day, but has been slow to reach, the path tracing great loops back and forth through a deep and narrow pass. Which looks like that. We will walk on. You have not seen a living soul since you left the Svin. So you are naturally cautious when you round a bend in the path and see a beggar, crouched low against a rock, muttering to himself. The beggar. You stop, out of sight, behind an outcrop, but the beggar does not look like much of a threat. Let's wait and watch. They're right about that, my little, character, I guess, status, or... I don't know what... I'm trying to think of a word, but I can't think of it. The way I adventure or something, I'm cautious. So let's wait and watch. You watch in silence. The beggar is an unfortunate soul. His head twitches from one side to the other every few minutes, and he mutters and murmurs to himself, "They're hiding in the rocks, sir. Hiding in the rocks." Let's approach him. You call a greeting and walk over, and he leaps to his feet, drawing a short stick from inside his cloak. "Who goes there?" he demands. "What's your business in Khare?" "You don't work for the city, you're a beggar." Is that rude to call him old man? I would say this. Greetings, but I don't like the old man part. He may take offense. I'm a traveler. The man pokes a stick at you. Traveler? Traveling where? I don't know if I want to give away everything to this guy. Kharé. Obviously Kharé, but why? He prods harder. Answer me, you'll face the consequences. What consequences? Better you don't find out, he replies darkly. I am the city guard. No one enters Kharé except through me. And then, despite his age and clear ill health, he comes at you, waving his stick. I won't fight you. You tell him, you are unarmed. He waves the stick close to your face, jabbing a few times, but you push the point aside with one hand. All right, then, he declares. We'll settle this fairly. He tosses the stick to one side and raises his fists. The knuckles are blackened with scabs. Well, if he punches me, I'm going to get scabs on me. I still won't fight you. You reply, I mean it. The beggar makes a short braying noise like a laugh, and then lamps you on the nose. Lamps me? Can't say I've ever heard that meaning of the word. It is surprisingly painful, and he is readying for another swing. Step away. You step back, and with that, the fight seems to drain from him. He sits down again, suddenly sad. Very well, he moans. You're right, I suppose. I can't defend the city on my own. You'll get yourself killed. Oh, no, he replies. That's exactly what won't happen. If that was my fate, it would have happened a long time ago. He shivers. You don't have any food, do you? He asks sadly. Given we have one ration? Sorry, no. You lie. I'm not giving you my last ration. The man sighs and shakes his head. No matter, then. There's plenty of meat on a grass vole if you know how to nibble 'em. Ooh. Okay, after the mini-mite, I forget his name, mentioned in the intro there. Or was it the outro? I don't know. I've had enough of travelers coming with us and messing up. Yeah, the other one took magic. I don't know what he's going to do. Good luck. I found a clue. A clue? What? He nods to you. And to you. He scratches up his brows for a moment in concentration. And listen, there are archers on the wall. The watchword is Cantapani. You thank him and take your leave. The path winds through gorse and thick grass. Learning some new words today. Kharé squats in a basin in the hills like a stagnant, festering pool. You turn one corner, then another, and then the stone walls of the city are looming over you. Talking to people will provide clues to help your quest. You can review your clues on the inventory screen. You have found one new clue. Alright, so let's check the inventory screen. Clues. The watchword for the wall of Kharé is Cantapani. Right, we have a net. Right, we have a Kharé gate key that you were given by the Sfin chief. Cool. I remember that now. Magical items. Two giant's teeth. I thought we only had one. That's cool. I guess we got two from that skull. We have one ration. Weapons is a regular sword. We should update that whenever we can. We have 18 gold pieces. I think that's... Is that the most we've ever had? 18? Not completely sure. Alright, so let's go to the end of the pass. Before the entrance is a wide open area that will take a few minutes to cross. You could scramble up the slope to the right to get a better view of the wall. Yeah, let's get a view of the wall. You scramble up the slope for a better view of the wall. It is formed of staggering, man-sized stone blocks, held together with gallons and gallons of mud and loam dredged from the base of the river. It curves away in both directions, unbroken except for the gate. And it looks like the old soldier was right. There is an archer posted on the battlement above the gate, watching the clearing. Let's look into the yard. You look beyond the wall into the south gate yard. It seems to be empty. A perfect moment to break in, then. I don't think I should be breaking in. Let's go down into the pass. I really don't want to break in. I feel that would be not a wise thing to do. I mean, can't we just get in legitimately? There is nothing else for it. You put up a hand and call out. The archer lifts a hand to shield his eyes against the sun. Who goes there? He bellows. Friend or foe? Friend, you cry. Ho, is that so? The archer shouts back. Then what's the watchword? The guard cocks an arrow and waits to see what you will do. Give the watchword. Hope is right. Catapani, you call. The guard considers this for a moment, then lowers his bow. Approach, he calls. Approach the gate. Okay. Wait, no. I clicked him too long. The south gate stands before you. It is as tall as two men, and would be broad enough to ride three horses through if only it were open. But instead it is locked, and there is no other way into the city. Luckily, of course, you have a key. Well, of course I'm going to use the key, but what happens if I knock? You knock firmly on the gate. It takes several minutes for anyone to answer, opening a small panel in the door. Who's that? A voice growls in the common tongue. It is not the same guard as the one above on the wall. Should I say Cantapani again? Cantapani. Cantapani yourself, he replies. There's one watchword for the archers and another for us infantry types. So don't think you're coming in unless you tell me who you are. I'm a merchant. Where's my wares? But telling him I'm an ambassador? I really can't say I'm a merchant. I have nothing with me. Unless I'm selling dice or something, but I can't provide anything to show him. I'm the ambassador? Okay. All right, then, the guard nods. Wait here while I check. He's checking, I can't bribe him much. I don't have that much money. Perhaps a few gold pieces might clear things in up more quickly. The guard smiles slyly, glancing quickly back across his shoulder. Then he puts his hand out to you through the window. Pay him. You drop... Oh, only two gold. That's not too bad. You drop the coins into his palm. As they clink, he coughs loudly to cover up the sound. Then, with a whisper, he tells you to wait a second, and then slams shut the little window. Damn. You wait. Otherwise, nothing happens. Knock again. After 10 minutes, you knock again. A voice curses from the other side. Then the guard's face reappears. Keep it down, he hisses. He opens a low doorway set into the gate and motions quickly for you to come inside. All right, going in. You step through the gate. We only go here inside the gate. Zoop. You enter the yard. But within moments, there are strong hands gripping your arms. Four guardsmen lift you bodily off the ground, more than you can fight, and with your hands caught, you cannot cast a spell. Oh, crap. I don't have that much money. Struggle? I don't think demanding justice is going to do anything. You struggle, but against the thick-set guardsman you're as helpless as a fly in a web. You glare over at the guard whom you bribed, but he only taunts you with a mocking smile. You have been tricked. Well, it is the city port of traps. Let's stay quiet and cooperate. Reasoning that trying to denounce him will only make things worse. Exactly. Well, I was thinking. You stay quiet. You are frog-marched across the yard to a low stone building with barred windows. Frog-marched. That's another note. Let's wait. Well, I'm going into jail, apparently. Another man is waiting by the door to the prison with a bow across his back. He nods. That's the one. She knew the watchword, but I knew there was something wrong about her. The door is open, and you are thrown inside. The door is locked behind you. You have been in Kharé for 2 minutes, and already you are a prisoner. Doing great over here, guys. And now I have to voluntarily move myself into the prison, even though I'm already there. Huh. You brush yourself down and look around. The walls are stone, and the windows are barred. A bench against one wall is the only piece of furniture where an old man sits. He is dressed in dirty robes and seems in a sorry state. I want to greet him. We can get more clues by talking to people, right? They didn't take my gold or my rations, which is good. You step towards the shadowy bench. Greetings, old man. That's exactly the thing that I didn't want to say, because I thought it would be offensive. He ignores you. He is concentrating hard on something on the ground just in front of him. A collection of small stones, scattered as though for a fortune-telling. After a moment, he gathers them up and tosses them again. You notice that his other hand is missing completely. The left sleeve of his tunic hangs limp by his side. Now we can cast a spell. I don't know what I would be casting. Kind of curious what we're going to do about him rolling stuff increases chances. I'm just glancing quickly. Unless I'm going to put him to sleep, or... which I need a brass pendulum for that. Lose morale. Charm him. Yeah. Well, I could use a knock spell on the prison gate, right? Or door. Let's look at his stones. You step over to peer at his stones, but he snatches them up quickly into his palm. If you want to play, he says defensively, then you have to bet. Play what? Why? The man replies with a shark-like grin. Swindlestones, of course. Swindlestones? You ask, intrigued. Stranger in town? Don't know how to play? Better and better. He shows you one of his stones. It is a strange four-valued die. Now that's funny, because I was talking about if I was a merchant, I would only have, you know, room on my person to carry dice. Sit. He pats the bench beside him with one hand. Play. We can talk while I beat you. You'll have to teach me the rules. My lucky day, he grins with his one remaining tooth. It's easy. We each roll our dice in secret, but we bet on what we've rolled in total. You call if you think the other player has bid too high. The loser gives away a die. You go over to the bench, intrigued. All right, so we roll dice. We bet the total of both of our rolls. I'm not going to play this too much. The old man drops four dice into your palm and sweeps away a patch of dust on the bench for you to play. I'll go first, he says, waving his hand. Show you how it's done. If he's going first, why am I rolling dice? You roll your dice. The old man peers under his palm and sucks his teeth. The game is simple. We roll and bet on what's come up. So for instance, I might start and bet that between us we've rolled at least X. But we don't know what's on the table, so I'm guessing. Okay. I understand. If I think your bet is too high, I call. But I don't know what you've got. What happens if your bid is too high? What's to stop me bidding really high? I'm not completely sure what I'm doing here, guys, with these mechanics. Grm. Indeed. I can't see your dice, and you can't see mine. You only have what I tell you about what I've got. Oh, bid 3/4. But you may be trying to deceive me. Burp. If you believe my bid is too high, you call and we check. Otherwise, we keep bidding higher and higher. And then my own bid must be higher again. I don't know what the 5x is. If I'm just choosing a conversation, or what does the 5x have to do with it? And less likely to be true. And now I think you have bid too high. So let us see who wins. Oh, I'm bidding... I bid 4, right? Reveal dice. Only 3 twos. The old man wins the round. Alright. So what's your name? Bid 1/2. Okay, I see how it's changing on the bottom. What's your name? Doomed. Well now, a name's a powerful thing. How's that? Names get written down. Names get passed on. Name's a name. Reminded of Planescape Torment. I like to know the names of the people I meet. Even at games you don't know? Huh. I'm keeping it low, guys. I appreciate the concern. We'll see who we'll see who's getting worked up now, shall we? So he's calling, reveal dice. I don't want to play anymore. Each player has a set of four-headed dice, which they roll and hide. Players then bid on the amount of times a face value has been rolled across their own dice and their opponent's dice combined. Bids get higher and higher each turn. When one player believes their opponent's bid is too high, they can call to challenge the bid. The dice are revealed, and whoever loses the challenge loses a die. Losing your last die forfeits the game. Is he taking... We're playing for money here. So there's two, bid two ones. Here's a bid. So three twos. I'm gonna call. You've gone too high. The round is yours. Hee hee. So we already know this. Bid 1, 2. So tell me, what do they serve for food in here? He says doomed. I've not eaten in 4 days. Good thing I brought my own provisions then. Not much of it, though. I've got to win this one. I only bid 3 ones. All I need is 1-1 out of him. Ta-da! I do want to see if I can beat him. This might be a longer episode, guys, just because of this. And we need a good, like, choice to end off the game with. The episode with. So, where are you headed when you get out of here? I'm just visiting the city. The North Gate, Backlands. Interesting how they've paired up the gambling, the choice, with, these bids. The North Gate. The North Gate. Now, why ever would you go to the North Gate? No one goes there. Three threes. I don't know if I'm going to win this round. I'm heading for the Backlands. I knew he was going to call. Damn it. Damn. I don't have a one. I'm going to bid 1-1. Why does he say doomed? One, three. Two twos. Does he have a two? All he needs is to have a two. Crap. He won it all. Sucks for me. That's the game, the old man says with a beaming smile. And you lost. So here's our history. Huh. I didn't see that about the eyebrow. The old man takes a dive from your side of the bench with obvious pleasure. You're a liar. Three ones. So, he asks, raising his eyebrow. His only eyebrow. The other is just a jagged scar. Where are you headed when you get out of here? The North Gate. He leans forward with a twinkle in his eye. We didn't see that. The old man beams and removes one of the dice from your hand. The old man takes a dive from your side of the bench with satisfaction. The old man pockets his dice once more and stretches back, cheerful at his victory. I thought you were a bit slow. Thanks for the game. You say, standing once more, I see I have a little still to learn. The pleasure was mine, the old man says, putting his dice back into his pocket. He leans back against the stonework and hums quietly to himself. Did I talk to him some more? You take a seat on the other bench from the old man, who is fussing with his empty sleeve. Tell me how I can escape this place. You turn to face the old man. Oh, it's simple enough, he replies. In a day or two, the guards will let you out. Once they've decided you're not an enemy, they just take a while to consult one of the mages. And if I don't want to wait? The old man shrugs. Then you cast a spell and get that door open. You are a sorceress, aren't you? I hope I haven't got locked up with a normal. You stand from the bench once more. Okay. Not too long after all. Yeah, so this is our decision. It's not much of one, but it's a decision. Should I wait and play it safe, or should I try and escape? So let me know in the comments below what you think I should do, and thanks so much for watching. I'm going to try to make the episodes a little smaller, a little shorter, just so, you know, we get more decisions in. The other episodes are rather long just because, you know, that's the way it turned out. So thanks again. See you next week. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.